Hi everyone, I'm Aidan O'Brien from Saber Astronautics. I'm the head of infrastructure and analytics, and today's talk is on workbench to flight. So you might also notice that there's a second logo on the screen here saying Open Galactic. That is a Saber sub-brand for all our open source stuff, which will come in play in a couple of slides. So today I'm going to talk about our approach to space operations and where today's theme fits in. The engineering workbench, which is running on some of our software that we open sourced earlier this year, including Open Galactic, which is our open source branding. The connectivity between two of our frameworks and products called Scepter and Javelin individually, and how they connect up to one another. Basic approach of getting into space with a space mission, transitioning, and then what happens with Saber's full mission operations. I'm not going to be talking about any of the other services, such as the CDF that we discussed earlier this morning, or space plane awareness, space traffic management, etc. Those are separate talks. So, Saber provides full stack mission services for all stages of flight. Today we'll be discussing the Scepter and Javelin and the mission operations fall into pre-flight, on-orbit, and end-of-life handling. Launch providers come out of our RSOC and mounting there, and the conceptual design is the concurrent design facility. And a couple other extra support services we provide. And this is the end result, where the RSOC operations and our front-end software more on Piggy, where we can do all the fault detection, identification, and rectification or recovery, where you can actually examine all the components of the spacecraft in 3D linked to the telemetry item so you can see at a glance the actual alerts rather than sifting through massive amounts of data on spreadsheets and whatnot, making the actual fault detection process even in the manual things before we include machine learning and other automated tools. Much, much faster, like orders of magnitude, days faster. So, Open Galactic, it's the open source space operations software. We went with an open core model, where we have the main core, which we've called Scepter, which is our command and control software. We've open sourced that. You can go to opengalactic.com, it finds you there. And we've released all the code based on GitLab. We've gone with the Apache V2 licensing at worst case scenario. There's a couple of MIT licenses, so standard open source licensing, nothing funny in there. So you can literally just go through and see what you have to do and be using it legally. And I'm obviously there to say, we receive grant funding from the Australian Government's International Space Investment Fund as part of the open source space operations project, which turned into Open Galactic. So we've got two main components for the workbench. There are other open source libraries and tools on Open Galactic, but these two are for the flight, workbench and for flight. So Scepter is command and control. So it handles the telemetry, tracking telemetry and control command. Server-based, has API interfaces. We're actually using it in the RSOC based on cloud services, and we can provide abstracted interfaces downline to interface with a number of different services. Javelin is a ground station client, and it's more an example of how to do it. So if you were using something other than the QBOS that it's designed for, you can use it as an inspiration to write your own particular client for the ground station. For the workbench and connect to Scepter, and then we can do it. So the overall path is that you can actually use Scepter, exploit a database, and we can easily onboard you into the RSOC. So this is a general working plan and excerpts from our tutorial list that we're going to be releasing. That's a win. The tutorials are released online. There's more marketing decisions. They're written. I read them. They actually exist. But these are a couple of screenshots. So we essentially have the user or the operator connects to Scepter, which connects to Javelin, towards the satellite, connected via Ventures D. All works over standard TCP IP connectivity. So you can have one engineer working on commands and telemetry structures, and another one working on the hardware in different rooms, and as long as you're on the same network and configure it, you can talk to each other, and it utilizes a standard Postgres database. And then you can also analyze data coming back, which is classified as the stream of the user. So if you want to get feedback and do further analysis. For this, it's specifically for Cubos or the new Cube OS. Probably needs some modifications to match with Cube OS, but you can just replace Javelin to match your use case and use the same API interfaces with Scepter. Oh, there's a missing one there. Okay, so when you want to transition from the workbench and go into the first mission, you'll be like, you've got all these questions of how to build your ground station now, what you're going to be doing. You obviously need a ground station to talk to the spacecraft in space. You've got to have operators to actually run it, and then you run it. So that's a very, very basic first steps that most, as a first attempt, getting onto an ops floor, and it usually doesn't work too well. So that's the basic ground station where you literally just throw in a ground station and you don't know what could go wrong, because at the end of the day, it's designed around having a person there sitting there talking via API to your spacecraft and getting all that sort of feedback. But you might notice, if it was that easy, that there wouldn't be ground station operators and mission control services. So there's basic pros and cons. If you want to take a photo of it, go for it. But anyone who's dealt with ACMA knows the joy of licensing a ground station. And while you might not want to do that, you actually need to buy the ground station hardware or build it. There's limited locations you're allowed to transmit from that aren't going to be restricted. You need to develop all your ground station software, make it reliable. You don't have any alerting, no automation, no redundancy if something goes wrong. You have to train your operators that you've never done before, and if the overpass is at 2 a.m. and you've got no way of actually scheduling it, you're up at 2 a.m. running your spacecraft. So Saber has the RSOC Responsive Space Operations Center, which solves that. We have a whole bunch of things like mission dynamics, like orbital determination, conjunction assessments, all the planning. We have space situational awareness and our space traffic management responses to it. And then we have the mission control and ground segment. So I'm not discussing the first two today, but we obviously do them. And they're not going to be included in the diagrams. So just imagine the diagram that I'm going to throw up is about 10 times worse. So this is our general Scepter as core ground segment design, where you can actually see that there's a whole bunch of automation talking to our ground station network. We don't actually provide any ground stations of our own. We have partners who we interface with and communicate through, each of which has a different API interface and its API interfaces. So a lot of these individual boxes are like 5 or 6 services underneath them, all grouped together, that I've just met. Otherwise, this would be too confusing to understand. Number of databases, alert service, telemetry streaming to end users, identity access management, all to get just your basic mission running and being able to automate things out. So if your overpass is at 2 a.m. or on a weekend, it'll handle it, and if you've got an alert and something goes wrong, or you can automate it out. Hey, I want to send a command, wait for a response. If it's within these bounds, send the next command, or send an alternative command, alerting you thresholds or machine learning, all that sort of stuff can feed through to a lot more complicated way. And that's pretty much it. Any questions?